Hello, everybody. Andrea Twarowski here with Dentalelle Tutoring. So let's talk about the cementoenamel junction. Okay, so this is for dental hygiene students and dental assisting students. So this is something that you have to know for the board exam. I suggest printing off an image, making a chart for yourself, but knowing the percentages, because this is a very easy question to get right, but also a very easy question to get wrong if you're not memorizing things. So let me show you guys the image that I found. I'm going to share my screen here, and this will just be a quick thing to help you guys study for the board exam. So your cemento-enamel junction is where the cementum and the enamel meet, because the cementum, as we all know, is the root surface, and your enamel is, well, your enamel, and that's your crown of the tooth. So if that is easier to kind of picture. So you have the crown of the tooth, and then you have the root on the bottom, but obviously that has to meet somewhere. But in 10% of the cases, where those meet, they do not meet all the way. So, and I have this image here, it says 5 to 10%, but in the textbooks, it says 10%. So, but it depends on the textbook you read. I'm not saying that this image is wrong, because it's not. It's always good to know the range, but on the board exam, it's even better to know an exact number. So where the enamel and cementum do not meet fully, that's about 10% of all cases. So yes, it says 5 to 10%, but I would make a note saying 10%. And then the next one is where the enamel and the cementum is kind of edge to edge, so they meet pretty much, is in 30% of cases. But then you have your last one where the cementum actually overlaps onto the enamel, and that's about 60%. So see how it says 60 to 65%. So yes, that's not wrong, but the best answer is 60%. So I'll do that one more time. So in 10% of cases, the enamel and cementum do not actually meet. So that's not a large number. In 30% of cases, it's edge to edge. And then in 60% of cases, the cementum overlaps enamel, or enamel overlaps cementum, you know, however you would like to say it, but there's overlap. So make sure to know this for the exam for dental assisting students and dental hygiene students, because this is a very common question to ask. Whether you're in Canada or the States, they like to ask this question. So I hope this helped you guys. If you guys have any questions about that, but that was pretty simple, right? If you guys have any questions, just let me know, and I will see you in the next one.